Severe Tropical Cyclone Debbie will be remembered as a large and destructive cyclone. And as with all significant cyclones, the name Debbie will be retired from the list of Australian cyclone names. So now let's take a look back at the path and weather of Severe Tropical Cyclone Debbie. The tropical low that eventually intensified into Severe Tropical Cyclone Debbie developed on March 22nd in the Northern Coral Sea. And the environment here was favourable for the low to intensify into a cyclone because sea surface temperatures were around 30 degrees, giving lots of energy to the system, and because there was low vertical wind shear, meaning that there were no dramatic changes in wind speed with height that would act to tear the system apart. Over the next few days, as the system developed, it drifted south, and it was named Tropical Cyclone Debbie at 10 a.m. on Saturday, the 25th of March. And those favourable atmospheric conditions meant that by 10 p.m. on the 25th, it had reached Category 2 strength, at which point it took a turn towards the coast. Over the next 24 hours, the upper atmospheric conditions became less favourable, so development of the system stalled. But once the conditions became favourable again, Debbie rapidly intensified from Category 2 to severe Category 4 strength during a 12-hour period on Monday, the 27th of March. And we can also see from the track that at times the cyclone slowed down and wobbled around in its path. And these short-term fluctuations in speed and movement are common in tropical cyclones, and they make forecasting the timing and location of landfall all that more challenging. And as Tropical Cyclone Debbie moved closer to the coast, Hamilton Island began experiencing sustained winds of 100 kilometres per hour or greater. And these continued for around 11 hours before the cyclone crossed the coast and 3 to 4 hours after that. And a peak wind gust of 263 kilometres per hour was recorded in the morning of Tuesday, the 28th of March, and that's severe Category 4 cyclone strength, and the highest wind gust recorded by the Queensland Observation Network. The centre of the eye crossed the mainland near Early Beach at 12:40 p.m. on Tuesday, the 28th, and shortly after crossing, the system slowed down to around 7 kilometres per hour, which meant that places slightly inland from the coast, such as Proserpine, were exposed to the very destructive core of the cyclone, with wind gusts up to 165 kilometres per hour for many hours. Further inland, roofs were blown off at Collinsville, where Category 2 strength winds were experienced. Coastal inundation from storm surges were reported at many locations. A 2.6 metre surge was recorded at Laguna Keys, with reports of significant inundation to homes at nearby Conway Beach and Wilson Beach. The system weakened below tropical cyclone strength in the early hours of Wednesday, 29th of March, and started to move towards the south. In the 48 hours to 9 a.m. on the 29th, Clark Range recorded 986 millimetres, and in the 24 hours to 9 a.m. on Thursday the 30th, Mount Duke recorded 635 millimetres. These periods of heavy rain led to reports of significant flash flooding, and with several locations in the Fitzroy River Basin receiving up to 1,000 millimetres of rainfall over 2 days, major flooding of the Fitzroy River resulted, and it eventually peaked just below 9 metres at Rockhampton the following week. As ex-tropical cyclone Debbie tracked south over the Sunshine Coast and Brisbane on Thursday the 30th, damaging wind gusts were observed, along with widespread rainfalls between 150 and 250 millimetres, resulting in major flooding of the Logan and Albert Rivers. A record major flood level was reached at Bow Desert on the Logan River. And in the same 24 hours to 9 a.m. on Friday the 31st, even heavier falls were recorded in the Gold Coast hinterland, where Upper Springbrook received 602 millimetres. We also saw the dramatic impact of this extraordinary rainfall over the northeast of New South Wales. The quick deluge saw rapid rises of river levels in much of the Northern Rivers area, with major flooding of the Tweed, Brunswick, Richmond and Wilson's river valleys. Lismore and Murwillumbah were heavily impacted, and many areas in the region received more than 500 millimetres of rain in 24 hours. The flood peak at Lismore was 11.6 metres, which is higher than the levels recorded in the 2001 and 2005 floods, but lower than the record of 12.15 metres in 1974. Our thoughts are with all those affected by Severe Tropical Cyclone Debbie. We would like to thank the community for taking heed of the warnings, and acknowledge the volunteers, emergency services, local and state governments for their tireless efforts in helping the community prepare for and recover from this disaster event.